Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to optimize the startup time of an independent integration server using the IBM int command. This capability was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise 12.0.4, so you'll need that level or higher to make use of this capability. The IBM int command has been extended so that the startup time of an integration server can be optimized. The capability can only be used for an independent integration server. It cannot be used on an integration server that is managed by an integration node. The IBM App Connect Enterprise documentation fully describes this capability. Under the link for modification pack version 12.0.4 enhancements, you will see there is a section optimized integration server startup. And if you follow the link, you can see the section on how to configure App Connect Enterprise to use this capability. Server optimization is suitable when the contents that are deployed to the integration server are fixed, i.e. you are not intending to deploy anything further to the integration server. This means that the integration server can start up faster in cloud container environments. This capability allows you to reduce the startup time of the integration server. This is based on what is deployed to the integration server. This allows an integration server that is configured to run in a container to start quicker and use less CPU, which will reduce licensing costs. So we have a tutorial which takes you through this new capability. I can open the tutorials gallery, and if I search for optimize, I can see the tutorial which describes how to use this capability. So if I click on start, I can see the overview of what the tutorial does, and I have a link to import the projects. So I'll import the project. And I can see that there is a flow with simple HTTP and reply nodes, and it has an eSQL compute node. I'm going to create a test server, which I will use to deploy this flow to, and then I will optimize the integration server. I'm going to set a preference, which allows me to keep the console logs when the test server is started at different times. So that is under connection settings, and I'll just tick this box here. I'll click apply and close. So I'm going to create a test server now. So the test server has started and I can view the log here. So I can see that the test server took 14 seconds there to start. I'm going to deploy the flow using the flow exerciser and put a test message through. So the message has been sent, and I've got a response back. And I have the application and the message flow deployed to the integration server. So I'm now going to stop the test server. And I'm going to open the command console and run the IBM int command to optimize the integration server. So I'm going to change directory to the directory of my workspace. So I can find that by going to properties of test server and selecting the workspace directory and change to that directory. And I can see the test server directory inside the workspace directory. The test server is stopped currently, so I'm now going to run the IBM int optimize server command. I'm going to run it with a verbose option. So the command has been run. It has identified that eSQL is required by this message flow. After running the command, a server.components.yaml file has been created. The server.components.yaml file contains a list of the main components which can be loaded when an integration server starts up. It has separate sections for runtime components like the JVM, the different types of nodes, resource managers, and flow security providers. So you can see that it has calculated that it does not need most of these components based on what is deployed to the integration server. The only things that are enabled are ESQL and JVM and Node.js. So if I return to the test server and now start it up and open the console log for it, I can see extra information in the log file which says which components have not been loaded, and I can see that it started at 10:15:19 seconds and it finished starting up at 10:50:25 seconds. So it only took 6 seconds there to start up, whereas previously the integration server took 14 seconds to start up. So a very marked improvement on starting the integration server by optimizing the integration server. So the flow is using an ESQL compute node, so we definitely need to keep that loaded. But we could make a further enhancement, which is to disable Node.js. So that should give us a further improvement. So I can edit this file and I can set this to false and save that. And now if I stop and start the integration server, we should see an even better improvement in the startup time. So if I open a console log now, I can see the runtime component Node.js has not been created, and I can see that it started at 10:52:27 and finished at 10:52:31. So it only took 4 seconds to start the integration server after not creating the Node.js runtime component. So it has started even faster than before. A consequence of not starting Node.js is that the REST administration API cannot be used, which means that if you do try and start the web user interface, it will not be able to show the contents of what is deployed to the integration server. So cannot connect to that port. In addition, after an integration server has been optimized, you cannot redeploy an application. If I attempt to redeploy the application, I can see there is an error here, and it is telling me that the integration server has been optimized and it is not possible to deploy to an integration server which has been optimized. This behavior is for the user's own protection, because optimizations which have been applied to the server are sensitive to the deployed content. This is not a problem for independent integration servers running in containers, because in situations where you wish to deploy something new, the container would normally be torn down and replaced with a new configuration. So, in this video, I have shown how to optimize the startup time for an integration server using the IBM int optimize server command. A new file called server.components.yaml is created, and you can configure this file to determine which components should be created and which components should be loaded. This allows integration servers which are configured to run in a container to start quicker and use less CPU. And this will reduce licensing costs.